Hello guys, myself Arun and today I am going to teach you about the Shannon-Fanon coding algorithm. Shannon-Fanon coding algorithm is mainly used for data compression. So our data set is given to you or will be given to your question paper. Say data and their probabilities of the data. Say x1, x2, x3, this 3 will be given to you. Now this is x1, p of x1, p of x2 and p of x3. Now say this has the p of x1 is 0.5. Sorry, writing it once more. This is 0.5, 0.1 and 0.4. Say this data is given to you. So this is not in decreasing order. So first what we have to do, you have to make this set in decreasing order. So what we do in the first step, arrange the data in decreasing order. So what we have to do in this set, or what necessary changes we have to do in this set, we have to just convert or rearrange with x2 place at x3 and x3 place at x2. So p of x3 will become 0.4 and p of x2 will become 0.1. So this goes our first step. Next step, what we have to do, we have to divide this set into two subsets in such a way that the sum of the probabilities are equal or almost equal to one another. So I am writing in words. So what we have to do, divide the given data set in such a way that, or into two subsets, such that sum of set 1 is equal or nearly equal to set 2. So what we have to do, simply we have to make this data set into set 1 is here p of x1. I am dividing it into two sets such that sum of these two sets are almost or equal. We can get equal over here, so I am approaching for equal. And set 2 is p of x2 and p of x3, because as you can see, the sum of p of x1 is equal to 0.5 and sum of set 2, that is p of x2 and p of x3, is equal to 0.4 plus 0.1, which is equal to 0.5. So that we have to do. Now our next step, that is step 3. What we have to do? We assign 0 for all the probabilities of set 1 and 1 for all the probabilities in set 2. So what does that mean? That means first we have to assign 1, oh sorry, 0 to the set 1, because set 1 is P of x1. And what we have to do in the next step, that is we have to assign 1 to the probabilities in the set 2. So that we have to do. So now this is it. Again, in the step 4, what we have to do? We have to, continue this process until and unless each of the two sets are not going to divide anymore. So that means you have to continue these three steps until and unless there is no partition is occurred, or we can do any other partition. So that is it. In my next lecture I will show you with an example. If you like the video and want some of your friend to understand this topic, please share it. Thank you.